Well, I spoke of building the relationships. The big change I've seen at our school is the teacher leadership, not just the three of us that are in the emerging leaders program, but the advocacy of strong teachers becoming leaders among their team, and even encouraging those who may not have been leaders before, but finding those strengths in them and pushing them to be leaders as well.
And with Charlotte, just taking an opportunity to really look at our core beliefs and looking at how those core beliefs drive our actions every single day. Whether you have been teaching for 20 years or 2 years, we can all take that opportunity to examine ourselves in a greater way so that we can be sure about the daily practices every single day. And it's every student every day. Every day, every student. And if we lead it, if I lead in that way, then I believe that that has the ability to impact the culture of the school.
For me at the middle school level, I know that one of the things that we did during our turnaround process was that we had to figure out how to deliver instruction to our students that would meet their needs. We knew that it was not going to be a one-size-fits-all plan, so we had to really take some time thinking about who were the students in our building and what is it going to take for us to move our students and what was it going to take for them to get it. From there, we came up with a list of instructional norms for our teachers in the classroom. Every day, you must do these 10 things to engage your students. And we found that when we began to think differently about instruction and move it away from a pencil, a piece of paper, and a desk, that that was the thing that really, really motivated and moved our students.
I feel like being a part of a Project Lift school is kind of like a perfect marriage in terms of new leaders in Project Lift. A lot of what we focus on in new leaders is, you know, pushing teachers' practice, supporting teachers, also developing teachers to be leaders, as evidenced through the Emerging Leaders program as well. So I feel like a lot of the training that I've gone through has definitely supported me in those efforts, as well as being a part of a Project Lift school where there's definitely a focus on attracting and high-performing teachers, and also supporting those teachers who are high-performing. Oftentimes, we focus on the teachers who struggle the most, but it's important for us to really reflect and really provide those supports to those teachers who are actually doing well and are going above and beyond what they're asked to do. So I feel like I've been supported in both ways.
I feel like when I was growing up that the teachers were kind of teaching just a whole curriculum, teaching to the middle, where now we are trying to look at every individual student, to look at the data, to drive the instruction from the data, to meet the need of every child, and of the whole child in every aspect.
I believe that a part of the magic bullet is ensuring that everyone has a voice. Parents being at the core of that conversation. Community. Businesses. We all want our students to be prepared for colleges and careers. But in order to ensure that that is a reality, we must be sure that everyone has an equal stake in the conversation. So that magic bullet in my mind is not leaving anyone out. We can't afford to leave anyone out. So it's simple, but I think that sometimes we struggle with bringing everyone to the table.
Thanks, Dr. Reese. One thing, sir, I appreciate your question so much, and just one thing I'd like to add from a national perspective is that we are looking not only at the 1,000 new leaders that are in the field, but we're looking at the results of educators like yourself and when they're successful. So whatever record we have of success, we're trying to grab that success and distribute the knowledge to others so we can do it faster. And I think that's the power of our national movement, is we don't have a magic bullet. Our magic bullet is whatever works for kids.
I think radical change is going to take some leaders, or a leader, such as the ones sitting here and the ones that spoke earlier, to step outside of the box and really think about education differently. And I think that it takes teachers knowing every single kid in their room, where they are, where they've been, what is their background, what is their home life. When I got to CMS, I had been at a Title I school and felt that I would come here and thrive as a teacher. And I was so wrong. I failed my first year here in CMS because I was not prepared for the urban challenges. But the fighter in me said that I cannot let the kids beat me at this game, and I've got to do something differently. And that was my movement for change. And that's when I became invested in the work of the students at Cochran Collegiate Academy. We have got to move this school. We have been at the bottom. We have no choice but to move up. But it takes radical change, and it takes a vision.
Absolutely. With that vision and the radical change, I would also say the resources as well. And Project Lift is definitely an example of how we can come together and put together resources that will best benefit students. So, but also think the strong leadership. And I think that really cultivating and continuing to keep leaders who are not afraid to kind of buck against the system in terms of, and really advocate for what's right for our students. And I think that, just leave it there.